Every school year, there were always days when students had to do special assignments.
Good morning, everybody.
Some were easy, like Thanksgiving.
Your assignment is to write a report about what you're thankful for.
And Martin Luther King Day.
Your assignment is to write a report about what you would dream about if you were about to be shot.
Some were a lot harder.
This week is my favorite holiday, Earth Day. Or as you would say, Chris, Earth Day. Inga, binga, binga, bunga. Chris, what tribe are you from?
I don't know.
Let's celebrate the day Chris's people finally realized they were emancipated. Happy Juneteenth, Chris. Oh, Chris, look at you. You didn't have to bring any food. Sometimes I forget how strong your people are.
What do you mean, how strong my people are?
What do I mean, how strong your people are? You shall overcome someday. Excuse me, can you be quiet?
Miss Morello?
Chris, I'm sorry for shushing you. I know your people can't help talking in the movies. Why aren't you in school?
Oh, I'm sorry. I just wanted to see this movie. I didn't think missing one day of school would hurt.
Chris, I know you must be a big Ernie Hudson fan. Thalmus is too. But do you think Ernie Hudson cut school to go see Gary Coleman movies while he was growing up?
Gary Coleman made a movie?
This time, sing it with feeling. You're singing about an impoverished family living in the ghetto who gave birth to their firstborn child in a manger. Chris, you can relate to this, can't you?
Not really.
All right, give me a minute and then we'll try it again. Oh, poor Chris. Winters can be so tough when you can't afford heat.
I've got heat.
You did horribly on your test. Put that on your record, it could seriously harm your chances of going to college. Even if you get a basketball scholarship.
I thought that test didn't count.
Chris, everything counts. You should know that. I would expect Greg to get suckered in by someone saying that, but with all your street smarts, you should know better than that. I'm sure with all the careers available in hair care companies and dance show hosting, it's hard to decide. But you're gonna have to apply yourself, even for that. And Malvo, with the proper education, you could do so many things. You could be a garbage collector, garbage truck driver, garbage truck dispatcher. The list is endless. I brought something special for you.
If it's my baby's mama, I hope she doesn't have feathers.
A brown egg?
They're all the same. On the inside. I'm gonna show you the gifts I brought back.
Gifts?
For you, I brought back a shield and a spear.
Well, what'd you get me? What is that?
It's a bone for your nose, silly.
The American Revolution began. Greg. Greg!
1942.
Greg, what's wrong with you? You're usually so alert.
It's because he's staying at my house for the week.
Oh, my God, he's drunk? Did he have a 40 for breakfast?
I'm not drunk. I'm just not used to getting up so early.
Don't be ashamed. Chris's people have a history of being up when the rooster crows to go to work in the fields. Who could expect you to keep up? Go back to sleep.
She was Don Imus in a dress.
Chris gave it to me.
Chris, I'm so disappointed in you. I know that nicotine, pork rinds, and malt liquor are the black man's vices.
You forgot white women.
I need to talk to you.
Yes?
You realize this week is our pizza competition.
I know.
My request for the school to provide you with an alternate victory meal of ribs and pig's knuckles was denied. But I know as well as you do that you loves you some pizza, right?
Right.
After years of being alone and ostracized, you now have a soul brother. Somebody to talk jive with and to shoot dice with. To talk about being raised by Madeir with. Just seeing the two of you together would make your leaders like Dr. King and Uncle Remus proud. Oh, happy day. I know you and Chris are having fun shucking and jiving together. But you should really spend more time studying. I want to read about the real black men who walked the gritty streets of the hood. People like Superfly, the Mac,
Black Belt Jones, Truck Turner, and Blackula. Tell me the truth about the pimps and the hustlers, the violence, all set to a jazzy beat.
Oh, this is a jazzy beat I want to give her. Right upside the head.
Maybe I can have you apply under the minority curve.
What's that?
It's an affirmative action plan.
The plan being, if we let one in, maybe they'll leave us alone.
Well, what do I have to do?
Well, first, you have to be black.
Check.
And then, you have to take the admittance exam, and if you pass, they'll pay for you to go. It's a full scholarship.
I'll do whatever it takes.
All right, then. I'll help you out.
Oh, this is great.
Thanks.
Now, give me some skin. I've always wanted to do that.
Run before she makes you tap dance.
We should have another opportunity to hear our candidates in addition to the town hall meeting. So you're going to have to prepare a speech.
A speech?
Oh, by the way, are you going to need an organ player?
Why would I need an organ player?
Well, you know, in case you catch the Holy Ghost.
No, I think I'll be okay.
Just for curiosity's sake, what else did you promise?
A TV in the library, more field trips, instituting recess, and no more detention.
Chris, how are you going to know how to act when you get stopped by the police if we don't give you detention?
Chris, we have an uneven number of boys and girls, so I thought I'd make you a single father. I know it's something you can relate to with your childhood and all.
I have a father.
Oh, I know, Chris. If only your mom knew his name.
Class? I just want to let you know that I won't be here tomorrow because I have a funeral to attend.
Who died?
My sister.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thank you, Chris. It's hard because I don't have 19 or 20 other siblings like you.
You have 3 children, right?
Yes.
Can I have their father's names?
Their fathers? No. They have one father.
Do you know his name?
Where are you getting this information?
I'll tell you where he's getting it.
Unfortunately, I think Chris is a crack baby. The mother's a little delusional. Her brain is addled by years of drug abuse and cheap wine spodiote. She's actually convinced herself that she has a husband who works 2 jobs and that they own a house in the ghetto. You can't believe a word she says.